Hi friends, welcome to my channel picfunmedicosis. Hope you will be fine. Please subscribe my channel for colorful medical videos and latest medical updates. My motto is medicine should be interesting. Today we will discuss important signs of meningeal irritation. In my previous video I have discussed the Kerning sign in detail. Please follow the link above to see that interesting video. Today I will discuss about the Brudzinski sign. Brudzinski sign is an important sign that is used to diagnose meningitis. And what is meningitis? It is the inflammation of meninges. And what are meninges? Meninges are the coverings around the brain and spinal cord. There are three layers of meninges: dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater. Dura mater is the toughest layer or durable layer. Arachnoid mater is in the form of mesh or net, and pia mater is the thinnermost and innermost layer of the meninges. There are three layers: dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater. Dura mater is the outermost layer, arachnoid mater is the middle layer, and pia mater is the innermost layer that covers the brain and spinal cord. There is a mnemonic to remember these three layers. Dura mater is the outermost layer, arachnoid mater is the middle layer, and pia mater is the innermost layer. Between dura mater and arachnoid mater is the subdural space, and between arachnoid mater and pia mater is the subarachnoid space. What is the difference between meningitis and meningism? Meningitis is the inflammation of the meninges, and meningism is the pseudomeningitis. It is a set of symptoms similar to that of meningitis but is caused by non-meningitic irritation of the meninges, usually associated with febrile illness, especially in children and adolescents. Which one is the most sensitive sign of meningitis? In 1909, Brudzinski reported that Brudzinski's sign is the 96% sensitive and Kerning sign is 57% sensitive. And which one is the most specific sign of the meningitis? Study was done on 297 patients with suspected meningitis to determine the diagnostic accuracy of Kerning sign and Brudzinski sign. Study shows that Kerning sign has specificity of 95% and sensitivity of 57%. So Brudzinski sign is the most sensitive test of the meningitis, and Kerning sign is the most specific test of the meningitis. How to elicit the technique of the Brudzinski sign? In step 1, patient is positioned in supine, and in step 2, gently grasp the patient's head from behind and place the other hand on the patient's chest. In step 3, gently flex the patient's neck, bringing chin to the chest. So in step 3, gently flex the neck towards the chest. And in step 4, positive sign is involuntary flexing of hips and knee, an involuntary reaction to lessen the stretch on inflamed meninges. What is the pathophysiology or mechanism of Brudzinski sign? When neck is flexed, the movements of spinal cord within the meninges that cause pain is cancelled by the flexion of hip to prevent pain. This is much like two persons pulling on either side of a single rope. So this is an involuntary reaction to lessen the stretch on inflamed meninges. Brudzinski sign is positive in meningitis and subarachnoid hemorrhage. There is a mnemonic to remember these two confusing signs. Brudzinski sign and Kerning signs are confusing in most of the cases. So these can be remembered by this simple mnemonic. Brudzinski, word Brudzinski has letter B and bent neck has letter B. So Brudzinski, B for Brudzinski, B for bent neck, B for Brudzinski, B for bent neck. And Kerning sign, the word Kerning has letter K and knees have letter K and K for kick. So K for Kerning, K for knees and K for kick. K for Kerning, K for knees and K for kick. So you can easily remember by this mnemonic. Please share my video and please subscribe my channel for other interesting videos.